This topic will cover bacterial tonsillitis and how we can use the Centor Criteria and FeverPAIN Score to determine if a patient will benefit from a course of antibiotic therapy. Let's start by discussing what is tonsillitis. This refers to the infection and inflammation of commonly our palatine tonsils, which sit at the back of our throat on the left and right side. The causes can be split into viral and bacterial, most commonly being viral tonsillitis, and an example is the influenza virus, which also causes the common flu. It's a self-limiting illness with symptoms normally resolving inside 7 days, and because it's viral, we do not use antibiotic therapy. On the other hand, we have bacterial tonsillitis, and the most common cause is group A streptococcus, also known as streptococcus pyogenes. Another example is streptococcus pneumoniae, which is a common cause in community-acquired pneumonia. And for bacterial tonsillitis, we need to use the Centor Criteria or FeverPAIN Score to determine the likelihood of bacterial tonsillitis and if the patient will benefit from antibiotic therapy. The Centor Criteria is broken down into four components, and each of these will score 1 point if examined. Therefore, the maximum is 4 points, and the higher the score, the more likely we're dealing with bacterial tonsillitis. The first part is lymphadenopathy, which refers to the swelling of lymph nodes in the cervical region of the neck. After this, we need to check for the presence of white pus, also known as exudates, at the back of the throat. In addition to this, we need to check for the absence of cough and record a temperature of greater than 38 degrees Celsius. And to remember the Centor Criteria, we can use the leaf mnemonic, which takes all of these parts into account. We can also use the FeverPAIN Score to determine the probability of bacterial tonsillitis. This is split into 5 parts, with each part scoring 1 point. Therefore, the total is 5 points, and like the Centor Criteria, the higher the score, the more likely we're dealing with bacterial tonsillitis. The parts include a fever within the past 24 hours, the presence of pus on the tonsils, the patient attends within 3 days of the symptom starting, the appearance of severely inflamed tonsils, and finally the absence of cough or other coryzal symptoms, which would be more in keeping with a viral tonsillitis. After working out the Centor or FeverPAIN Score, we can use this to determine the appropriateness of starting antibiotic therapy. For the Centor Criteria, remember the maximum was 4 points. Therefore, if the patient scores 3 points or more, then it is deemed significant to start antibiotic therapy, because the likelihood of it being a bacterial cause is up to 56%. For the FeverPAIN Score, remember the maximum was 5 points. So if the patient scores 4 points or more, that is a significant level, because the probability of it being a bacteria is 60 to up to 65%. We will now talk about the management guidelines for bacterial tonsillitis. The first step is to always clarify if the patient has an allergy to penicillin. If they do not have an allergy, then the first line is to prescribe a 10-day course of phenoxymethyl penicillin, which is also known as penicillin V. And we prescribe a 10-day course because we expect to achieve a microbiological cure within this time frame. Having said that, most patients will feel much better within 5 days of starting antibiotic therapy. If the patient has a penicillin allergy, but they're not pregnant, then the first line is to use clarithromycin, which is a macrolide antibiotic therapy. If the patient has an allergy to penicillin and they're pregnant on the time of presentation, then the first line is to use a different macrolide, such as erythromycin. Having said that, whether it's bacterial or viral tonsillitis, you always want to give self-care advice. For example, recommending paracetamol for analgesia and making sure the patient keeps on top of their hydration status, ensuring they drink as much fluid as possible during this time of illness. As in the case in all areas of medicine, it is vital to provide the patient with safety netting advice, which means that they can seek medical attention if their symptoms continue to persist or even deteriorate. And at this stage, you may need to consider an alternative diagnosis. For example, if the patient now complains that they are unable to open their mouth, which is known as trismus, and they complain of a change in voice clarity, which is known as a hot potato voice in textbooks, we need to consider a diagnosis of peritonsillar abscess, which is known as Quinsy. And the picture on the left shows the arrow pointing towards a tonsillar abscess, and the oval actually shows the uvula has deviated from the center point. And in this case, we would need to actually refer the patient immediately to hospital for surgical incision and drainage of the abscess. Therefore, it is important to remind the patient to seek medical attention if there's a change in their health status. Thank you for watching this tutorial on bacterial tonsillitis. We covered how to use the Centor Criteria and the FeverPAIN Score to assess the appropriateness of antibiotic therapy and the current management guidelines for bacterial tonsillitis. Hope that was helpful.